couple years ago, Donald Trump planted a story that Ted Cruz's dad assassinated John F. Kennedy. And then a couple months later, Ted Cruz endorsed Donald Trump. So today, I'm going to ask Ted Cruz to sign this. I'm sure he won't have a problem with it.
No, not on that.
Why won't you sign it?
Because I've seen your silly videos.
It made everyone so weird and sad that they had to come out here.
Look at yourself in the mirror!
This evil body!
Evil spirit!
He's possessed by a demon!
Ted Cruz looks so weird. Hold on.
I'm gonna say it. Ted Cruz.
Well, I guess Ted Cruz has watched our videos. So, Ted, will you endorse us to be president?
Oh my God. So those are the good liars. We love the good liars. They actually joined us for an interview a few weeks back. You can find them on the channel. They really have it in for Ted Cruz though. And you can kind of understand why. If you've been following American politics, Ted Cruz isn't maybe the worst Republican substantively. There are others that are worse, but he's just really bad in a lot of different ways. And there, they decided to hone in. You can see there. Let's give you the full picture of that National Enquirer headline. National Enquirer back in 2016 was totally in the bag for Donald Trump during both the Republican primary as well as the general election, running headlines attacking his primary contenders as well as Hillary Clinton. So they claimed that his father had potentially helped to assassinate JFK. It's ridiculous, but whatever. It's not a serious newspaper. They can put out their headline if they want. But then Trump jumped on it saying, and you know, his father was with Lee Harvey Oswald prior to Oswald's being, you know, shot. I mean, the whole thing is ridiculous. What is this, right? Prior to his being shot and nobody brings it up. They don't even talk about it. That was reported and nobody talks about it, but I think it's horrible. Well, maybe they don't talk about it because it's ridiculous. It's ludicrous. It didn't actually happen. But that is what the guy who would go on in the relatively near future to become the Republican nominee and to become president of the United States decided to use to take out Ted Cruz. And thank you to the good liars for making sure that Ted Cruz, for reasons which we'll get to in a minute, never forgets about that. Brett, what do you think?
Ted Cruz is the most pathetic Republican, hands down. Hands down, the most sad, pathetic clump of garbage. And we can get into this later, but in that situation, like just talking about Trump's quote specifically, Trump is a guy who says that the media is fake all the time when the media frequently is telling the truth and just reporting facts about him. And he's now saying like, I'm just asking questions and taking as a lead a headline from the National Enquirer about Ted Cruz's dad helping to kill Kennedy.
Yeah, that's like, ridiculous. So he is. Dumb. You're right. I think the word is pathetic and needy, oily. He's that sort of bad politician. Nobody likes him. Nobody likes him on the left. Nobody likes him on the right. Someone reminded me, and I checked the quote to make sure that it's true, but Al Franken had once said, I like Ted Cruz more than my other colleagues do. And I hate Ted Cruz.
Yeah. So, Ted Cruz is a blobfish. Yeah. You know that.
Except blobfish is kind of cute. Like you kind of have like a little bit of sympathy for the blobfish.
Well, looking at Ted Cruz phone banking for Donald Trump, don't you have a little bit of sympathy for that little blobfish? The angle of him on that is the same as the angle of the blobfish in the blobfish meme.
Exactly. And I'll remind you of one more. Do we have that second shot? Okay, let's go to the second shot.
Just once, I'd love to see a Republican candidate stand up in a primary and say, I'm a moderate establishment squish. I stand for absolutely nothing. It would be refreshingly honest, at least. I know. But nobody says that. And by the way, they all pledge their love for Donald Trump. I love Donald Trump. No, no, no. I love Donald Trump more. No, no, no. I have Donald Trump tattooed on my rear end.
Let's see it. Come
on. I like you, but not that much.
Okay, so he thinks that it's pathetic that all these Republicans are constantly genuflecting to Donald Trump. And I agree to him. I agree with him, except that he's one of those people. That is him right there, phone banking for the guy who insulted his wife's appearance on Twitter, who called his dad an assassin, a killer of presidents. You're the guy that you're mocking, Ted Cruz. That's what you are.
Yeah, and when it's like he called his wife ugly, no need to spill the, you know, images are worth a thousand words. He's calling Ted Cruz's wife ugly. And Ted Cruz does that. And when someone's like, prove it, Ted Cruz acknowledges in a way instinctively that he is one of those Republicans who did that exact same thing. Yeah. Ted is a sad, sad excuse for a man. And in that, homeboy was at, it looked like he was at a McCormick for US Senate rally, and McCormick is running against Dr. Oz, who's endorsed by Donald Trump. So there is some kind of fallout there, it looks like. But
he's trying to pretend that he can be strong because he's willing to support a candidate that Trump doesn't like. But if Trump runs for president again, he's definitely going to run and go support him so that he can keep the favor of the party. So he's like trying to briefly pretend that he's strong, but we're not going to forget who he actually is.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.